Oh, yes. Neil recently broke the record by managing 1,602 games and joins us nearly a month on from his departure from the Borough. Neil, good morning, Neil.
Morning, Alan, and morning, lads. Yeah, 1,603, morning. Alan, by the way, that last one.
Oh, is
it? Well,
the West Brom go. One. Super Sam again. He's
even though
so
I got
super.
The sack before the game, he count it. I'm sure you count it.
Neil, how much of a surprise was this when suddenly said, sorry, it's all over, Neil?
Yeah, it was a surprise.
Surprise me.
But you don't, you know, I did fear the worst when director of football come in and never looked me in the eyes. I thought,
oh, really?
Yeah, I thought, aye. But the worst part was, I only found out on that Saturday morning and I took the game and everything. And then I went straight in next morning to get to clear my desk and couldn't get in the training ground. You know, I mean,
no. What do you mean couldn't get in? They wouldn't let you in?
There's a meeting, you know, there's a press conference with the new manager and chief exec. And I said, what? They couldn't wait.
You obviously barged your way in then.
Yeah,
get
out of there. No, I went away. Come back.
Did
you? I mean, just a total lack of class, really. That's what I was big disappointed in. After. Oh. You know, I think I've done a good job there. I've cleared all the heavy wages out and they've got a great group of lads.
Neil, why is it that when you know, people, troubleshooters, come in, do this, do that, get rid of bad wood, get rid of the big earners, we can't afford them now, da-da-da-da-da, and then you do your job, you have a few injuries. They're not sensational results, but they're all right.
4 points, four points off playoffs. I mean, crikey.
Right. Suddenly you're shown the door.
Yeah, I know. And listen, I understand that they've got to look to the future, but if they've got to look to the future, why didn't they do it in the summer then? This manager that's currently there was free to take over in the summer. So I don't understand. They either want me to have a go. You know, I don't think the director of football were planned. And like I say, it was obvious from day one that he wanted his own man in and the chief exec as well. I think they've been talking to Chris for a few
and
weeks.
And he couldn't look you in the eye.
No, never looks me in the eye. I thought there was something up then.
Neil, I was going to say to you, mate, listen, nothing surprises in football. I think
hey, that... listen, let me just tell you, Alan, the wounds are healing now in my back.
From?
From the departure, the wounds are healing
Well,
now.
Listen, mate, we feel your pain because we know what goes on in football, but the one thing that surprises me is, did you not get an opportunity to get in and say goodbye to... You know, when I say the staff, I mean everybody within the club, out with the footballing staff, you know, like the girls in the kitchen, all that kind of stuff. Surely an opportunity to say goodbye.
I went in the following week when I knew that nobody was in and said goodbye to the staff, etc. And the players were brilliant. On the night, I told the players, it was fun, I told the players 10 minutes before kickoff at West Brom that, listen, lads, I've been told it's my last game. I think you're an amazing group. We should be nearly top of the league now, but we're not. And I still think you've got a great chance of going up. But I want you to do well today. I want you to show people today how good you are. And really, I think the ball hit the goalkeeper on the face, in the head. It stopped out in the last minute. And we'd have won 2-1 if that had been the case. And then they talk, you know, like they talk about lack of fitness, etc. Well, we must have been fit that week.
it's unbelievable, isn't it? Yeah. Trev, what do you make of all this?
Yeah, no, listen, I feel I'm talking about lack of class, you know, not allowing you back into the training ground. I just think it's people's fear because you've got so much knowledge, so much experience, Neil. I think they just feel a little bit out of depth so they don't want you anywhere around them. What's been keeping you busy since you've in the last month? Baking, gardening, walking, golf.
No, we went straight up to Scotland, up to Dunoon, and I went to Tinnabruch, Ali.
Tinnabruch,
magic, Neil.
I mean, what a view over that top of the hills.
Sensational. They're going to say you went to Tina Turner, corner. Tinnabruch, absolutely beautiful. Just round from Colin Tribe, up that hill at Tinnabruch, looking down the Kyle.
That's right, yeah. So we took the dogs up there. We had a great couple of weeks, so that was good. And then it was, you know, glad to move, and we're back in Cornwall now. So it's... I'm going to be obviously regular at Plymouth now, right? Ryan Lowe, young manager, doing really well down here with the Green Army. So I'm hoping that they can get promotion this year.
Neil, I want to ask you, mate, because obviously the amount of football, we watch everything that's on the television. I personally think that championship might be the hardest division. Clearly,
big one tonight.
I'm not making any comparisons clearly between the quality of football, you know, what Manchester City, but in terms of the division itself, the Tuesday, the Saturday, it's an unbelievably difficult division to play in and compete in. Is that a fair comment?
It's the most difficult league, I think, in the world, really. But I must tell you, Ali, I think it's going to be the easiest one this season to go up. Yeah. I think take Fulham out of it. I expect them probably to beat Bournemouth today. After Fulham, I think it's wide open, mate, for mm-hmm. teams like Middlesbrough. So I've never seen it as close as that before. Yeah. But they are. It's physically difficult, and you know, I think mentally, managerial wise, it's, you know, you've got your ups and downs, and now you. But I've been very lucky. I've had some, you know, I've managed to turn clubs around, and fans at Cardiff were amazing, and then Middlesbrough fans have been absolutely incredible. You know, the way support that we got, like at West Brom in my last game, it was amazing. So a big thank you to them, and like you say, I still think they've got a good chance, mate.
Neil, just looking at one of your old clubs, one of my old teams, Queen's Park Rangers, sitting in third at the moment, looking very strong, you know, with Chair, Austin Gray, they've got goals in the team. Have they got a chance to go up this season?
They have. I'm not sure defensively they've got a chance at that. I mean, they're third, so they've got a chance at the top two, haven't they? Because, like I say, yeah. I think there's only Fulham, etc., with the squad they've got, the depth of forwards they've got. But... he's done well, Mark, with the young lads. He brings the young lads through, and you know, they've got a good philosophy there. That, and you know what it's like, Trev. That's a fabulous. I used to love managing. That's old fashioned football, yeah. Isn't it? With that crowd on top of you, and so thankfully they're not having a new stadium yet. But I think I think they've got a chance.
Neil, just we're hearing we heard from Michael Carrick earlier. Done really well coming in. He's now decided that's it. In comes Mr. Rannick. How difficult is it, or could it be, when you come in, you know, midway through a season, busy time coming up, Christmas, New Year. How difficult is that coming into a new club as a manager?
It's difficult, but I think everybody sort of wants him, which helps. Everybody wants a new guy to come in. They've all been pushing for it, so everybody will get behind him. I think his problem, at any level, will be he's coming in to play a way that he believes in, and you've got world stars, like you've just mentioned, record-holding goalscorer Ronaldo.
Yeah, who incredible.
I don't think we'll be able to play that way, so he's got to find a system, because you can't leave somebody like that out.
Yeah.
So he'll have bigger problems, you know. I think I found the Premier League was more difficult because of the power of the players, whereas the Championships, I think you can still build what I call your bread and butter players. I love going into training this year with my players, whereas in the past, in the Prem, once or twice, I wish I could have stayed in bed.
Yeah. What about, you know, so Rannick goes in, and United, it looks as if they're going to pick up form now. What about the other end, like Everton? Rafa makes an incredible, you know, jump from Anfield. All right, not right away, he goes to different clubs, but Rafa now in at Goodison. You've got both sets of supporters, they're not, you know, you get Liverpool fans are unhappy. What
I'm probably the wrong one to ask about that, because he threatened to sue me, I think,
when
I was on about him playing a reserve side against Fulham last game, next to last game when they threw it away.
Well, it'd be fair to say then, Neil, that he can't be enjoying this at the moment.
Oh, I hope he isn't. I hope he isn't enjoying it, if I'm honest. Yeah. I hope he keeps his job for a few more months, mate. If I'm honest. I can't be fairer than that, can I?
Oh, dear. Oh,
what did they say? What goes around comes around.
Oh, so are you watching much football at the moment, Neil, or are you just chilling out?
A couple of weeks ago, somebody caught me saying I wouldn't watch another game of football when I retire, but now that's rubbish. I do enjoy football. I'll tell you what I enjoyed. I know it sounds silly because it wasn't a great game, but I enjoyed Norwich at Newcastle the other night, the emotions, the way the fans, unbelievable fans, got behind the 10 men. And then, you know, I like Dean. I think Dean Smith's a good bloke. You know, I think both managers are, you know, very, very good people. And so it was interesting to watch that tactically.
Do you think they are down then? The Norwiches, the Newcastles, people, you know, the stats tell us Newcastle are down. They will go down. But look, I still think it's tight down there.
Oh, it is tight, and they will buy players. But the problem they've got is which top player will want to come if they're going to get relegated. I'm not sure, you know. If I was him, I think I'd be looking at the top players in the Championship that could play Premier League to sort of try and get them out. Are you with me? Because there's some good players. We've got some, you know, your Dale Fry, who's been injured since, you know, for about last couple of months, really, which we've missed. He's probably the best centre-half in the league. And you look around and there's some really, really good players around. So I think if I was, you know, that sort of manager, I think I'd try and get the players at these clubs that are, you know, that can do a job, rather than, you know, looking for the foreign lads who will take 6 months to get used to it, you know. I don't think they've got time for that. I still can't see them getting out, really, if I'm honest.
Neil, you just mentioned, I think I know the answer to this. Obviously, the game's changed a lot over the last 30, 40 years. But you just touched on it there, good people, with the Newcastle-Norwich game, talking about Dean Smith and Eddie Howe.
Yeah.
Is that still imperative in whatever, whether it's a player, whether it's a coach, whether it's a manager? Is it all about good people?
Well, obviously different managers have different styles, don't they? I've got my success by building a dressing room, really. And this, the one I have built at Middlesbrough, playing-wise, is probably as good a footballing side as I've ever had in my career. You know, all right, we had a lot of injuries, and like I say, we were sort of four or five missing from the squad. But I love the dressing room spirit, and that's what I miss more than anything, that going on the pitch and having a go at Sol Bamba, or, you know, asking Johnny Howson if he wants to borrow my stick and things like that. You know, I do enjoy those moments. You know, so see Duncan Watmore score two cracking goals last week, and I had a right job to sign. He played for 6 weeks without any wages when he first came. I had to talk him into signing him. So it's great to see things like that. I still get a kick out of seeing players that I brought through, you know.
So you're not done yet then?
Well, that's what I was going to say to you, Neil. 1,603 games is absolutely remarkable. It really is. It is absolutely remarkable. However, knowing you as I do, I wouldn't be ruling out 1,604, 1,605, 1,606. What do you think?
Well, I know you said never say ever, you know, but we have really enjoyed our time in Scotland. I'd like to go to Italy a little bit more now, as I spoke to you about before.
Yeah.
There's one or two places we'd like to see, so there's no way, you know. I think it's about time, really, and you can't keep bringing those recordings of me on half-time talks, can you? And every time you know, and there are some nice conversations with me that you could play, but it doesn't seem to. Hey, I'll tell you how bad it is, Ali. At the moment, in front of me, I'm started reading Alan Brazil's book. That's how bad it is.
By the way, Neil, with the greatest respect, you'll be finished at about 10:30.
Look at the pictures.
By the way, Neil, when he was going on about 1602, 1603, I thought he was going to keep going to 1690, but I won't come to that. So will I see you down at Cheltenham, March?
No, I only go to Cheltenham occasionally, don't I? I'm not a racer like you.
Oh, come on, you loved it.
I loved it. Listen, one of my biggest enjoyments was that morning when we went down. Ali, we went to the Guinness bar. He said, come and have a drink, right? So we went down to the Guinness bar. There was, what do they call Princess Anne's husband? Tyndall.
Mike Tyndall.
That's him. Yeah, he was there with us. And I hope he
Zara's husband.
Oh, sorry, Zara. Yeah, right. Yeah. So I asked. He came down with us and Alan, and there was four of us, and we went to the Guinness bar, and he ordered three pints of Guinness. What are you having, Neil? So I said gin and tonic. Well, I had a gin and tonic, and I soon realised that these lads had drunk these pints before I'd put the lemon in. So I went
Neil,
to the bar.
Cheltenham. It's Cheltenham Festival.
I went to the bar. I give the kid 20 quid behind the bar, Ali, serious. And I says to him, every time they come now for their drinks, I want you to just give me tonic and say it's a gin and tonic. Or I don't want any gin in it whatsoever. And by 11:30, they'd had 9 pints, Ali.
It's Cheltenham.
Well, how can I enjoy Cheltenham? I wouldn't be able to see a horse after 10 o'clock.
That's the aperitif. That's the start of the day.
Oh dear. Honestly, I've never seen out like it, me.
Have a great weekend. Enjoy the book, Neil. Don't worry about that. TalkSport Breakfast with Laura Woods. Monday to Wednesday morning, 6 till 10. On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app, and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.